The most devastating horror movie of our time. So realistic it's shocking. So shocking it's unreal. It's horrible. SGM Pictures presents.
Like, who's Dilla? What's up with Dilla? Cold steel. Cold steel.
I can't give you a specific year, but I guess it's whatever year that the Office Space soundtrack came out. Slum Village had Get This Money on the Office Space soundtrack. It was pretty odd, pretty random for that soundtrack. But I remember my friend Tara telling me I should check the song out, and I actually really, that's when I first was cognizant of the work.
And a bunch of artists sent in pieces and work and music that they heard of J. Dilla that inspired them to create some pieces. So we got a bunch of different mediums in. Somebody went from, photograph that symbolizes vibrant thing when a J. Dilla's track, donut chain, bling chain. So we got a lot of good different pieces and came out pretty dope.
One of the owners of Fresh Tetic is a good friend of mine. Opened me up to the art show that's going on right now. I heard donuts, so I molded and casted a donut and covered it with sparkles.
On the other hand, for me, it was just all subliminal consciousness. Being part of this show, you know, as a visual artist and a music producer, for me, it was a good look. You know, mine energy that he brought was cut short on this planet, and he's up there in heaven with Jam Master Jay, which is why I titled my piece Ram Master Jay, JayDee.
When I first heard Beats, Rhymes, and Life, I have to say I didn't like Beats, Rhymes, and Life. I thought it was not good, not because of the beats. I thought the beats were amazing. I loved Get a Hold. When I first heard Get a Hold, I was just, like, that was my track. Like, loved the beat. There were some other joints on there that I really enjoyed. So that was the first time I heard him and the first time I fell in love with him, but I didn't know who he was at the time. I don't think I really kind of put two and two together until I started hearing some other things. People started kind of talking about, oh, it's like Jason Chad. You know, you go back into your liner notes and then you start connecting the dots.
Just excited about tomorrow. This is our sixth donuts. We really enjoy putting it together. We do it on a shoestring budget, so I'm glad that everything came together this year. I'm sad that one of our partners, Christy, isn't going to be up here, but, you know, she will be with us in spirit.
Some of the records where I really, really, like, fell in love with what his sound was he did. There was that Keith Murray remix that he did. Some of the records from Far Side that he did. Early Busta Rhymes and some of those Boomer records that he did from Quest were just, you started to recognize exactly what that sound was. And it was just, it was really fresh, it was really funky, and it was something that was, it just sounded different than anything. A premiere beat, like you hear the beat, you know it's Preem, and then 15, 20 seconds, you hear a P-Rock beat, you know that's P, 15, 20 seconds. Those Dilla records were records that you knew it was that sound, and you, for me, what wound up happening was, I later realized that that sound was Dilla.
Around the time that he started recording with Farsight, that's when he got on my radar, and I followed him ever since. His entire catalog just moved me, and there was never a set that I play without playing something that he's had his hand in the production.
Long strong. Speed is broke. global music ambassador and former tour DJ for Jay-Z. And I'm here at Dress Up Forever, number 6.
When did I first fall in love?
It's funny because I was falling in love with Dilla's music and not even really necessarily knowing that it was Dilla.
Actually, the first time I felt like truly fell in love with Dilla was when I listened to Slum Village, Fall in Love. I used to play that record over and over.
My friend China's house, and I heard her play remix. I was trying to check out the credits to see who produced the track, and it said like Slum Village remix, and I was like, Slum Village, I never heard of these guys or these cats. So I went online and just tried to dig up everything I could on Slum Village, and then just started finding their tracks. They needed me away just hearing like all the instrumentals. It just had that whole tribe feel, that feel good music. It was crazy.
The second track on the Donuts album, I was working at a coffee shop and we used to put on our own music. And as a staff, we put on the Donuts album and we're all, you know, slinging coffee. The second song drops, the first time we hear it, we literally stopped in our places. And for a moment, we're like, you know, we froze because we were so stunned by this track.
One, two, three, let's go!
You looking stiff, I said you took it there. What's up with you? Hey, what's up with you? What you gonna do? You want me, don't you?
Want me, don't you?
I know you do.
I know you.
Yeah, I want you too.
I want you too.
You wanna do me?
I would say in 2000, when I first heard Fantastic
it's the 788 DTM, just like Jake the Snake. Actually, we don't participate, but if you do, then I'ma see you at your way. Don't let the drama fluctuate. I don't wanna, I gotta, we cooking steaks. Now where would we be at if we let you do that? We probably be laying on our backs. Talking this and
I always listen to it by myself in my crib, in my studio. My stereo system wasn't bumping like that. I realized that Dilla's music is crazy loud like this. You know what I mean? It sounds Dilla. It sounds real good because you can really actually hear the bass. Like, you really literally need a system to really appreciate Jay Dilla.
Here's the sound and substance of the world's hottest entertainment.
My name is Eric Kim.
People call me DJ Echo.
My name is Michael Sharp.
My name is Tara.
Sawandi.
Q.
My name is Todd Craig.
Sandrine.
Human.
My name is Vanessa.
My name is Defo.
Eric.
My peoples, they complain, sit and rave and rant. Your name is out my mouth like an ancient chant. Got me like a dog as I pause and pant.
Yo, cause don't nobody care about us. All they do is doubt us. We blow the spot, then they all wanna crowd us. Don't nobody care about us. All they do is doubt us. Till we blow the spot, then they all wanna crowd us.
What's your name?
Camille.
and you've never heard of Jay Dilla.
Oh, and now that you say Jay Dilla, that brings him back.
This nigga Jay is the game, fucking Jay is the game. Jay is the game, but he don't play. Jay is the game, but he don't play. Hey, all the chicks that got Jay. Jay is the game, but he don't play. Jay is the game, but he don't play. Jay is the game, but he don't play. Jay is the game, but Jay is the game. Fucking Jay is the game. Jay is the game. Jay is the game. Jay is the game. Jay is Jay is the game. Jay is the game, but he don't play.
Let's go. Dave West, Dilla Dog collab. Hot, hot, hot.
So far,
turn it up.
Yup.
Oh, it's the boy with the heat, torching the beat. Of course it is me, but unfortunately. But you can hit me on the box. I'm busy on the block, getting 50 on the crop, yeah. Getting ready to bounce with Nitty on them gold dubs blowing right to a house floater out cold, bust up.